Roosevelt with Auto Network, and I'm going to talk today about driverless cars on my Business Hangouts on Air show. So if you are interested in driverless cars and want to know more about driverless cars, you want to give your opinion of driverless cars, tap on the icon at the bottom, give me some hearts. And if you're watching this on the replay, this is Roosevelt. We're going to be talking about driverless cars today. And if you can give me a minute here, see if I can get my phone snapped in here. But I'm in the process of, I'm setting up now for my show that will start at 3 o'clock. I always start a little early. And we're going to have a couple of guests on from Phoenix Marketing International, Brian and Marissa. And they're going to talk about a recent study that Phoenix Market International did on what automotive consumers really think about these driverless cars that are coming. They're also going to talk about who they think will be the manufacturer that produces the first driverless car, whether it will be a social site or an actual car manufacturer. But we talk a lot on Auto Network about driverless cars, about some of the issues that you're going to have with them in terms of who's responsible if you're in an accident. Also talk about safety. We talk about the fact of having driverless cars on the road with cars that are occupied by us, traditional drivers. Are driverless cars for people who really like to drive? It's going to be a big advantage for the handicapped. Can you imagine the blind or the people who can't get around, the paraplegics, will be able to hop in a driverless car and just speak where they want to go, and it takes them there safely. So that's one major benefit that I see for driverless cars would be for the handicapped. It will really be a game changer for them. And internally, the entertainment systems will be able to provide a lot of information for the handicapped. Even for the blind, there are some things that they're going to be doing for the blind in autonomous cars or driverless cars, as they're called. Several businesses now are testing driverless cars. Most of the luxury manufacturers are testing some driverless cars. Google has been testing driverless cars out in California for quite a while. They've probably been doing it longer than anybody else. And I think they've gotten approval to actually do some tests on in real world, in urban settings. And as far as I know, they've had about 14, 15 accidents. Most of them were rear enders, where the driverless car with a driver sitting in it, there has to be someone in the car, even though it's a driverless car, was not the fault of the driverless or the autonomous car. People just ran into the back of them for whatever reason. And most of those cars that Google uses on the highway for the test are the Lexus RX 350s, I believe. So it's not like it's an unusual car. It's something that you see on a regular basis. The RX 350s or RX models are very popular with Lexus, so you see them on the road all the time. So it's interesting that Google autonomous cars or driverless cars would have rear-end collisions. But in California, with bumper-to-bumper traffic, I guess that's what you're going to get. Fortunately, nobody was hurt, and there were no insurance claims that I'm aware of that resulted as a result of these few accidents that they've had. But I'd like to know what you think about autonomous or driverless cars. You can leave it in the comments. If you're watching the replay, you can leave some comments. But driverless or autonomous cars are what's coming. They're coming faster, and most people say it'll be 10 to 15 years, but I think it's going to be shorter than that. Probably within the next 5 years, you're going to see driverless cars on some parts of the highways, and probably out in California, where they're doing most of the testing. But they're coming. It's just like cell phones. You know, cell phones took off. They started out as the big old clunky devices that you had to carry around with a box, if you can remember that. And now they're small enough to stick in your pocket. Things that you can do on a cell phone now, you couldn't even imagine doing 20, 30 years ago. Same way with cars now. Things that you can do on some of the cars now you didn't even imagine 20 or 30 years ago. So driverless cars or autonomous cars is just the next thing that's going to happen in the auto industry. It's going to happen pretty quick. Let me know what you think. Leave comments as to whether you think autonomous cars are something that you would be interested in sitting behind the wheel and testing. Give me your thoughts on whether you think it's something that car companies should be doing. What would be your main concern with sitting in a driverless or an autonomous car? Would it be safety? Would it be reliability? What about hackers? You know, hackers now are all over the place. Driverless cars or autonomous cars are basically computers on wheels. So that's what Tesla has now, and the Tesla cars have been hacked. As you know, some of the Jeeps have been hacked. So what do you think about autonomous cars? You're sitting there with really no control, and a hacker takes over. But let me know what you think. This is Roosevelt. This is Auto Network. And I'm preparing to do my Business Hangouts on Air show. If you want to join in that show, which is coming up 3 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, you can go to autonetwork.com, follow the link to Talk Show. Just register right quick and you can join me at 3 o'clock. We're going to have a couple people from Phoenix Marketing International that just published their recent survey on what automotive consumers really think about autonomous cars. And you can interact with them, ask your questions, leave some comments, or just sit there and watch us as we talk about that particular subject matter. So I appreciate you taking the time to sit in on Periscope. I'll be scoping a lot more often. Really haven't decided what I want to talk about yet because I do several things. And maybe I'll just talk about a little bit about everything that I do. Auto Network now does quite a bit. We're pioneers in streaming video on the web, been doing it since the early 90s, put the first car company on the web with searchable inventory. We now have our own coupons, offers, and deals discount service where you can get coupons from car companies and other businesses that are doing business with Auto Network. And if you watch Auto Network, you'll be able to take advantage of all of those opportunities. So want to end the scope. Thank you for taking the time. See you next time. This is Roosevelt, and as always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. See you next time.